Well, good afternoon. Thank you all for joining us today. I'm Attorney General John Formella. I'm joined up here today by Portsmouth Mayor Daeglin McEachern, Portsmouth Police Chief Mark Newport, Portsmouth Police Commission Chair Stephanie Shaheen, and we've also got Deputy Attorney General Jim Buffetti from our office, and Sean Locke, who is the Director of our Civil Rights Unit at the New Hampshire Department of Justice. We're grateful to have everyone here today standing with us, both from the state and the City of Portsmouth, to discuss what is a very important topic. Over the past year, as you all know, we've seen an increase in the number of reported hate-motivated incidents throughout our state, but particularly on the Seacoast. We've been closely monitoring these developments, and a number of these incidents are currently under investigation by the Civil Rights Unit at the New Hampshire Department of Justice. Today, we want to specifically provide an update into one incident that took place in Portsmouth last year. It's an incident that we've partnered with the Portsmouth Police Department to investigate, and we have an action item today that we're going to talk about. On July 30th, 2022, the Portsmouth Police Department received reports that individuals were hanging signs from the Stark Street overpass, which overlooks Route 1 in Portsmouth. These signs had a racially motivated message. The officers who responded to the scene observed approximately 10 men on the overpass. They were wearing hats, sunglasses, face coverings that had on them NSC 131. NSC 131 stands for National Socialist Club 131. It's a well-known group, a well-known hate group that has been involved with a number of hate-motivated incidents in the Seacoast area. At the scene at the bridge were observed two signs that were hung up that read, "Keep New England White." NSC 131, it's an unincorporated association. It describes itself as, quote, "a pro-white, street-oriented fraternity dedicated to raising authentic resistance to the enemies of our people in the New England area. This takes the form of networking, training, activism, outreach, and above all, action," end quote. The incident involving the banners was referred to our Civil Rights Unit at the New Hampshire Department of Justice for investigation. And for the past several months, the Civil Rights Unit has worked closely with the Portsmouth Police Department to investigate this incident, to determine the identities of those responsible, and to also determine and look into whether the hanging of these banners constituted a violation of the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act. To date, we've been able to identify two of the individuals responsible that were at the scene. One was Christopher Hood, who we have concluded through his actions at the scene and other information that we've gathered is the founder and leader of NSC 131. The other involved individual that we have identified is Leo Cullinan, who we've also determined is a member of NSC 131. By its plain language, the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act prohibits certain unlawful conduct, including trespass, when that conduct is motivated by race. The enforcement of our Civil Rights Act is critical. It's critical to our public protection function. It's critical to ensuring that New Hampshire remains a place where people of all backgrounds feel welcome, and where people of all backgrounds feel that New Hampshire is a place where they can build the life they want to build for their families and build the life that they want to build for their children and future generations. Based on the information that we've gathered in this investigation, today we have filed civil rights actions against Christopher Hood, Leo Cullinan, and NSC 131. These actions allege that these defendants violated the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act when they participated in a trespass on Portsmouth property by hanging a banner without authorization that read, "Keep New England White." Based on the text on the banner, that action was motivated by race. These complaints were filed in Rockingham County Superior Court this morning. Again, as alleged in the complaints, the hanging of the banners on the overpass without authorization was a trespass because it violated both state law and a Portsmouth ordinance that governs the hanging of signs and other notices. The text on the banners, "Keep New England White," shows that the hanging of the banners was clearly motivated by race. So that's what leads to this being a clear violation of the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act and leads to us taking the action we're taking today. The complaint against Mr. Hood contains two counts, one for a violation of the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act and one for conspiracy to violate the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act. The complaint asks the court to impose a penalty of $5,000 for both counts, so a total of $10,000. These are the maximum penalties allowed under the Civil Rights Act. The complaint also asks the court to enjoin the defendants from committing future violations of the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act, from engaging in other unlawful activities, and other points that the injunction would cover. The complaint against Mr. Cullinan contains one count, and this is for conspiracy to violate the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act. In this complaint, we ask the court to impose a penalty of $5,000 for the single count. Again, this is the maximum penalty allowed under the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act. This complaint also asks the court to enjoin Mr. Cullinan from committing future violations of the Civil Rights Act or engaging in other unlawful activities. And finally, as I mentioned, we filed a complaint against the organization NSC 131, which is an unincorporated association, and because we've identified two individuals, we are filing a complaint against the organization itself. This complaint is for a violation of the Civil Rights Act, and it asks the court to enjoin the entire organization from future violations of the Civil Rights Act or other unlawful activities. The allegations in these complaints are merely accusations, and the Civil Rights Unit will have to prove these accusations by clear and convincing evidence at a final hearing. The actions we've taken today should send a strong message to all those who would commit unlawful hate-motivated acts in our state and to all of our citizens who are watching. And that's this. The New Hampshire Department of Justice will do whatever we can within our authority and within the bounds of the law to take action to enforce the New Hampshire Civil Rights Act. We will enforce the Civil Rights Act wherever and whenever we can, to the maximum extent possible under the law. We're extremely grateful to Police Chief Mark Newport and the Portsmouth Police Department for their partnership in this investigation and their ongoing partnership going forward in investigating other incidents that have taken place both in Portsmouth and on the seacoast. I can't say enough about the professionalism of the Portsmouth Police Department and the actions they took the night of this incident to immediately respond to the scene, to ensure that the activity stopped happening, and then to refer the incident promptly to the Department of Justice for investigation. We're very grateful for their actions in this case. We're very grateful for their partnership. We're also grateful to be standing here today with other colleagues and leaders from the city of Portsmouth who are showing their support for this cause and showing their support for the work we're undertaking together.